A state of calamity declared in some towns and provinces here in the Philippines due to Typhoon Tisoy. Tisoy downgraded to a severe tropical storm as it continues to weaken. All storm warning signals have been lifted. And the Philippines bags more golds in the 30th Southeast Asian Games here in Manila. Good afternoon. I'm Carmina Constantino. Dateline Philippines begins right now. Welcome to the program. Typhoon Tisoy has weakened, but not before wreaking havoc in several Philippine provinces. Among the hardest hit was Oriental Mindoro, where two people were reported killed. Local officials also set to declare a state of calamity to allow them to tap emergency funds for storm relief efforts.
Nakakalungkot kasi akala po namin kahapon wala kami masyadong pinsala. Ang dami kasi yung ating mga palayan po talagang pinasok din po ng tubig baha. Ano po, yung ating po mga saging, dapang-dapa din po. Yung ating mga high value crops na pinagkukunan po ng kabuhayan ng ating mga kababayan. Dahil sobrang lakas po ng hangin at saka ng ulan na binigay ni Tisoy dito po sa Oriental Mindoro.
In neighboring Occidental Mindoro, thousands were forced to flee their homes because of Tisoy. The province also plunged into darkness at the height of the storm.
Totally blackout po kami ngayon. Kagabi pa, kahapon pa nung pumasok yung bagyo, talagang totally blackout na kami. Tapos hindi upasable ang mga karsada namin ngayon. Ang daming mga bumagsak ng mga puno.
Catanduanes avoided a direct hit from Tisoy, but the typhoon still caused extensive damage in the island province, including its capital, Virac. Dennis Tatu gives us details.
The town of Virac in the island province of Catanduanes was one of the areas hit hard by Typhoon Tisoy. Trees were uprooted, their branches littering the streets. Power lines and business signages were no match for Tisoy's strong winds. This hotel was forced to suspend its operation as employees hunkered down while Tisoy raged outside. Some residents who refused to leave their homes ahead of the storm found themselves rushing to evacuation centers. Tisoy did not make landfall in Catanduanes, but its eye wall hit the island. When dawn broke, the wind slightly calmed down. And residents saw the devastation caused by the typhoon. Homes were damaged, roofs peeled off, and some houses no longer standing.
Kung pwedeng matulungan kami ng government, mas maganda.
Yung kusina po na tangay po ng dagat, sa sobrang lakas po.
Many roads are also not passable due to debris. In the town of San Miguel, the Battle River spilled its banks, causing flooding in the surrounding areas. Six villages are now isolated. Due to the damage, the town of Virac is now under a state of calamity. Power and water supply and mobile signals are still down in Catanduanes. Dennis Datu, ABS-CBN News, Catanduanes.
Entire province of Albay now under a state of calamity. Our correspondent Karen Cannon on the line now to tell us more about this. Karen, go ahead.
Yes, the entire province of Albay is now under a state of calamity after the onslaught of Typhoon Tisoy. The provincial council passed a resolution Wednesday declaring a state of calamity in the entire province upon the recommendation of Albay Governor Francis Bichara. This will allow the provincial government to tap into its calamity fund. Governor Bichara said in his recommendation that the quick response fund will be used for disaster response, rehabilitation, and recovery efforts of the local government units affected by Typhoon Tisoy. So far, power supply in Albay is cut off. The Albay Power and Energy Corporation, or APEC, is still clearing debris and damaged posts. It assures residents that they are doing their best to restore power, especially now that the Christmas season is approaching. APEC says as many as 529 primary line electric posts were damaged by Tisoy. Those lines will be prioritized as it carries the big amount of load from government offices and business establishments in the province.
Back in the newsroom, thousands of evacuees remain in temporary shelters as Tisoy slammed into parts of southern Luzon. Sherian Torres tells us more.
Racing against time, this fisherman from Cavite Province made sure that his fishnet and small boat were secured as rains brought by tropical cyclone Tisoy started to wreak havoc in the province. A previous typhoon that wrecked his first boat was more than enough to teach him a lesson, he says.
Pagawa na lang ulit.
Kanya-kanya?
Opo. Okay. Hindi, yung iba sa barangay dito, ito, puro sa barangay yan.
Oo, eh yung sa inyo?
Ay, ito bili ko po.
His colleague Norberto, on the other hand, kept watch on the sea. He says a strong typhoon like this would mean 2 straight weeks of not being able to fish for a small-time fisherman like him.
Naungutang na lang. Bahala na yung ano namin, kung ano yung may abot namin.
Meanwhile, many residents of this fishing community in Cavite City refuse to leave their homes unless their area is already submerged with water. Motorists traversing major routes in Cavite like the Silang-Tagaytay Road experienced almost zero visibility while driving. The heavy downpour prompted the evacuation of more than 800 families around the province. Along Calamba City's National Highway in Laguna Province, major roads were inundated for several hours, affecting motorists and pedestrians. The provincial government of Laguna recorded 2 landslide incidents at the height of the typhoon, one of which buried a connecting road for farmers.
Yung pong mga produkto namin gulay, dinadala sa iba sa Binyan, sa Divisoria, sa Pasay. Meron naman talagang ibang lugar na dadaan na merong tarsada na dadaanan sila, medyo matagal-tagal nga lang. Pero kung magagawa ng mas mabilis, mas okay.
More than 1,200 families were evacuated in Laguna, but the provincial government says they had 0 injuries and casualties. In San Juan in Batangas Province, houses made of light materials crumpled like paper after being hit by a 3-meter storm surge. Many trees also collapsed at the height of the storm. Garbage almost clogged waterways, if not for the government's cleanup drive. More than 200 families were rushed to evacuation areas, fearing a stronger storm surge.
Kakaiba ang nakikita nilang alo ng dagat at parang may narinig silang ugong.
A family offered rooms in their resort to evacuees for free. In Batangas City, this physically challenged individual was among the 3,000 residents who transferred to safer grounds.
Okay, mahirap po. Apat lang po kasi nagbubuhat sa akin. Katulad kanina, malakas po ang hangin at ulan. Eh, hirap na hirap po yung nagbubuhat sa akin.
The Provincial Disaster Management Office reiterates its appeal to others affected by the typhoon to proceed to evacuation centers and ensure their safety. Sharian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
Well, Tisoy has weakened further as it moves away from the country's landmass. Still a severe tropical storm, Tisoy is expected to continue to weaken and is forecast to exit the Philippine area of responsibility between Wednesday night and Thursday morning. All storm warning signals have been lifted. But State Weather Bureau Pagasa warns choppy seas and rains are still expected in several areas in Luzon.
Bagamat malayo na yung kaulapang dulot nitong bagyong si Tisoy, mapapansin natin may mga bagya pa rin ulap lalong-lalo na dito nga sa kanlurang bahagi ng Central and Southern Luzon. Bukod pa dyan, meron din tayong mayiral na amihan or northeast monsoon dito sa Northern Luzon. Mas makapal pa nga ang kaulapan lalong-lalo na dito nga sa eastern section ng Northern Luzon.
Meanwhile, despite bringing devastation in the regions, Tisoy brought some relief to Metro Manila's main source of water, Angat Dam.
Meron po kaming na-observe na halos 180 millimeters basin yung average ng rainfall within the watershed ng Angat. So, yun pong Angat Dam is tumaas po siya ng halos 4.5 meters. So, yung kanya pong present elevation as of 6 a.m., is 193.47. So, expected po din natin na sa mga susunod na araw, posible pa pong tumaas siya ng mga 2 to 4 meters. So, posibleng mabot po siya ng 196 to 198.
Well, the Philippine Senate is set to probe dozens of delayed projects under the Transmission Development Plan of the National Grid Corporation of the Philippines, or NGCP. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, chairman of the Senate Energy Committee, says there are 33 delayed projects under the NGCP, he adds. They will also look into possible penalties for the power grid operator.
A delay in the rollout of these transmission facilities will also delay a lot of the power plant that will go into the system. So even though we have a lot of power plants going into the system, but if we don't have enough capacity in the transmission lines, or the transmission lines will not be put up, then we will have problems with electricity shortage.
Aside from the delayed projects, the Senate will also investigate NGCP over China's 40% stake in the country's lone power transmission line. The inquiry begins later this month. Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte slams Ayala Corporation following a decision favorable to Manila Water, a utility firm owned by the Ayala Group. See, last week, the Permanent Court of Arbitration in Singapore ruled the Philippine government must pay Manila Water some 7 billion pesos, or nearly $137 million for losses incurred due to the non-implementation of rate hikes. But Duterte is firing back, saying government is being milked by huge corporations. He's also throwing grave accusations against the Ayala Group.
You know that Ayala, they do not pay Tanapin mo nga si Ayala kung saan puntahan ko. They do not pay corporate income tax. Ang corporate income tax, hinuhulog nila doon sa tao. Part of the binabayad mo sa tubig.
Duterte also threatening to file economic sabotage against senators supposedly liable for honors contracts between the Philippine government and water concessionaires. He adds he will ask the Solicitor General and his finance chief to write an amended water contract that is more favorable to government.
Bakit pumayag ang mga senador dyan? Marami yan sila. And we will expose them. And I will insist that they be tried for economic sabotage. Pag hindi nila tanggapin yung kaso na yan, I'll tell the Supreme Court now. Now is the time that we talk seriously. Nabilihan ng kaso. Ito, ipapile ko to. Economic sabotage, and I will arrest them.
Local utility firm Manila Water standing by the legitimacy of the arbitral ruling. In a statement, the company said the decision handed down by the Permanent Court of Arbitration in Singapore was meant to correct a breach of procedure during the previous administration. That's years after the firm responded to government's call for public-private partnership to solve the water crisis back in the late 1990s. Manila Water adding Finance Secretary Sonny Dominguez has already acknowledged its intention to work closely with government in finding a mutually acceptable scheme to address the award. As for Dominguez, he says government's legal team will craft an action plan to address the issue. Team Philippines remains in first place in the latest 30th SEA Games medal tally. With over 50 gold medals, the Philippines now has its largest gold haul since the country last topped the regional meet. That was back in 2005. Filipino actress Angel Locsin gets honored for playing her hero character Darna in real life. Locsin was included in Forbes magazine's annual Heroes of Philanthropy list thanks to her efforts in aiding those displaced by the Marawi crisis. Forbes also singled out the Kapamilya star for donating over ₱1 million to residents hit by the 2019 earthquakes in Mindanao. Locsin joins the likes of SM Group's Han C and Alibaba founder Jack Ma for the honor reserved for personalities across Asia who are committed to solving some of the most pressing issues facing the region. Well, Spotify reveals the biggest artists and songs that dominated its platform over the past decade. Drake came out on top as the most streamed artist in the world with 28 billion. while Ed Sheeran's Shape of You was named the most streamed track in the world with 2.3 billion. Post Malone, Ariana Grande, and Eminem round out Spotify's chart of most streamed artists. The most streamed tracks of the decade also include Drake's One Dance, Post Malone's Rockstar, Halsey and the Chainsmokers' Closer, and Sheeran's Thinking Out Loud. And that's today's online edition of Dateline Philippines. Thanks for joining us. I'm Carmina Constantino. Don't forget to like and share this video and leave your comments below.